so quiet. I'm not used to this. Let me try one more time. There's a little more feeling to be gotten out of that. All right, here we go. You know, a lot of times musicians will ask me, like, because I think my approach is a little bit unorthodox, so a lot of, you know, cats will ask me, like, what is I'm thinking about, or what my influences are, or this, that, and the other thing. Or, you know, and generally from the guitar player's point of view, I think what they're looking for is, whose licks are you copying, sort of, or some version of that. There's certainly guitar players that I've admired deeply, and I'm not above stealing licks from people, you know, but the real thing that I think in my weird journey with the guitar is that I'm always telling musicians, younger musicians, and then people on records, I'll say, you know, I'll have a kind of line, which is, I'll say, stop thinking like a guitar player, or stop thinking like a drummer, or stop thinking like a bass player, or stop thinking like a piano player, and just start thinking like an orchestrator, or really, the snarky thing is start thinking like a musician, and think past your instrument in all the things that tether you to the instrument. And so you start thinking about just what is your musical role in whatever situation you're in, or how am I going to create music, as opposed to how am I going to play the guitar, you know? I mean, it's no big, huge insight. I'm certainly not alone in having it, but it is surprising. Guitar is such a powerful magnet, and people love it so much. I love it so much, and I love all the classic language of guitar, in all its permutations, like electric guitar, rock guitar, jazz guitar, country guitar, you know, solo acoustic guitars. I love all the various languages that have been developed on it, but I feel like I do my best work when I just sort of let that all float in the back of my DNA, and I don't think about any of that. I just respond viscerally to the moment, and I don't respond as a guitar player. I just respond as a guy who's making music. So that's kind of, that's definitely my mindset, you know? So it's weird, like I have a kind of a yin-yang thing with the guitar where I both love it and I also feel it's a little bit of a burden. This is a hymn I wrote, theoretically the first track on my solo record, whenever that comes out. When I wrote this, it started me sort of thinking about making this solo record, because I thought, oh, well, that's pretty, and then I posted it on my one social media outlet, Instagram, and feedback was pretty positive. I was like, oh, well, people might like this. So, of course, I got bored with just doing solo acoustic guitar things pretty quickly, but I do like this piece. I can hear all my various influences on it, but I'm not going to tell you what they are. You'll have to figure it out. Thank you. tend to think the lighter the finish or the more dried out, for me, acoustic guitars become more appealing. A phrase that comes up a lot when I talk to people about old acoustic, I love old acoustic guitars. It's sort of my one material vice. I don't actually have a whole thing for electric guitars. Like, I don't actually even have like a old Telecaster. The oldest Telecaster I have is like 1970. And I've had that for 45 years, I guess, at this point. But old acoustic guitars, when they sound, for the most part, there's always exceptions, when they sound a bit dried out, like the finish is dried out, the wood is dried out, they're really appealing to me. Now, why is that? I'm not sure. I hear more fundamental tone. Even with this guitar, which I think is very dried out, actually, this is with new, relatively new strings, still sounds, the tones sound very uncluttered to me, which I like, very direct, comes out, you know, that's in part mahogany too, but... Anyway, to my ears, microphones love them, like dried out guitars, because there's less extraneous information for the microphone to capture, so they tend to sit on tape well, for me.